Okay, everybody, welcome back. I think it's now time for a little recap from last episode. First of all, Jacqueline Fine is lost in time and space, so at the moment she's not going to participate in anything that happens on the board. And instead of an encounter, she will actually have to flip over the lost in time and space restriction card, and then we'll see what happens. We also have a mystery, our third mystery, and we need to solve four, and we're actually on a clock here, which requires us to go to the Antarctica sideboard and solve four encounters altogether in order to solve this mystery. And we need to spend one clue each time. So let's look at the Antarctica sideboard. At the moment, we only have one investigator, Zoe, in the Miskatonic outpost. She needs to go to either the lake camp or the city of the Elder Things, which is over here. Now, she can actually go to the lake camp on this turn and then have an encounter there. She has two clue tokens, so on two consecutive turns, she could basically do two encounters and hope for the best. We also have I thought actually that we had two Plumb the Void spells. Yes, because this is quite important, because actually we would have to get more clues, obviously. And at the moment, the only person who has any clues is Lola Hayes and our friend Zoe. So what we're going to do is, now I'm going to move the camera again. We're going to take a look at our friend Akachi. Now, Akachi on the last turn was ambushed by this monster. Now, I've learned since then, and thanks to Pencil Polly for telling me, that once the ambush is done, this monster returns to the cup. So what we're going to do is, first of all, Akachi is going to take a rest action, then she's going to encounter this clue, and then we'll take it from there. She's going to take a rest action, and then she's going to cast a spell. She's going to cast Plumb the Void. Hopefully she will pass, and then she will move Lola Hayes to lake camp as well, so that Lola Hayes can have an encounter there to get two results for our expedition mystery card. Mystery card. So that's what we're going to do. So first up, our friend Zoe. She's going to take a rest action, so she's going to recover one sanity and one health. And she is also going to move to lake camp. That's her second action. Next up is... So she's going to take a rest action as well. So she's going to recover one health and one sanity. And next, she's going to try and cast Plumb the Void. She has a lore of 3, but she gets an additional die for her secret page tome. Since she's performing a rest action... she cannot recover health, unfortunately, because she's hypothermic, but she can roll a die. And if she gets 4, 5, or 6, she can actually get rid of her hypothermia condition. So let's hope for the best. Keep your fingers crossed. And she rolls a 1, of course. So she's still hypothermic, but she regained 1 sanity. So her sanity is now at 6 again. So let's see how she does on plumbing the void. She rolls 3 dice. And she fails. Okay, so that didn't work. So we cannot move Lola Hayes, which is a pity. But we have to flip this card. 0 to 1 successes. You remember that a swirling passage to an unknown world opened before you, but did you travel through it? If you did, where did you go? Discard this card unless you gain an amnesia condition. Yeah, well, we're going to discard this card because we've got another Plumb the Void spell. It's not essential. Okay, so now we need to rethink what we're going to do with Lola Hayes. Now let's see. Lola Hayes is now in the middle of nowhere, and if she wanted to go to Antarctica, she would have to take 1, 2, 3 travel steps. To Buenos Aires, to space 12, and then to Antarctica. Now she does have 1 sea travel ticket. So what she is going to do is she's going to first take a rest action. So she regains 1 health. 1 sanity, bringing her up to almost full sanity and 4 health. And then she's going to take, does she have any conditions? No. Then she's going to move to space 12, where she will encounter this clue and hopefully solve it as well. Okay, then next up is again our friend Zoe. Who has an encounter at the lake camp. Most of the dogs were killed, but some prints lead away from their pen. You search for survivors, test observation. Her observation is 1. And it's not a research encounter. Oh, she gets +1 to all skills because she has the markings of Isis. And when once per round, she may reroll 1 die when resolving a test, and she is also blessed. So we have 2 dice that we can roll. Note that we have been rolling very badly, so even having 2 dice and being blessed may not be enough. And she fails, but she can reroll 1 die, and she also has focus tokens. And she passes. It's a 4. She passes. Yeah, I almost said she failed, but she passes. If you pass, you find a few dogs hungry but alive. Gain 1 dog sled unit unique asset. If you fail, okay, she gains 1 dog sled unique asset. I hope this is something that we can actually use. Doggies. Ah, here we go. Dog sled. Unique asset ally. Action. Move to an adjacent space on the Antarctica side, on the Antarctica sideboard. Then perform an additional action. This is really good. Because she can actually then move to the frozen wastes, gather that clue. And so she has 3 clues and then move back to lake camp and have an encounter. Brilliant. So first of all, now we're going to spend 1 clue and put it on our mystery. Okay, this doesn't really help us a lot because we need 3 more rounds if we keep going at this pace. And the issue is that we then also have a 4th mystery. So I actually believe that either Doom will take over or we will have we will run out of Mythos cards. So I don't think we will win this game, but at least we're going to give it a very good try. So let's see. Lola Hayes over here is going to encounter this clue. In the sea. You discover an elder thing has been smuggled aboard your ship. You attempt to uncover its purpose. Observation minus one. Her observation is two. Minus one would be one die, but she gets one additional die because she has passed her personal story. So we're going to roll two dice anyway. And it's a failure, of course. But we have a... Yeah, and we have one focus token, which we're, of course, going to use. And we pass. Okay, so brilliant. If you pass, you realize it is studying magic. You realize it is studying magic. Gain this clue and one spell. Woohoo! First of all, we're going to gain this clue. Very good. Now we have two here as well. So she could go to Antarctica next turn, which is actually possible for her. Well, no, it's actually not possible because she would need another turn because she has no travel tokens left. But maybe by then we will have our friend back and we can plumb the void. And she gains one spell and she gets a clairvoyance. During the encounter phase, you may test lore. If you pass, you may choose to encounter one clue if you are on its space, ignoring monsters on that space. Well, it's a nice one, but it's not essential and doesn't help us very much. All right, so Lola passed. Let's look at our friend Akachi. She also gets to do a research encounter in a, I believe, city space. Yep. City. You attend a meeting of the American Archaeological Society. Something about the way they speak and act seems alien. Test will. Her will is four. Having said this, of course, die rolling, not my strength. It's not my strong suit, as they say. And of course, we pass. Wow, with 1-5, I don't know if you can see it actually in here, but it's at the very back, a 5. Very nice. If you pass, you resist their hypnosis, gain this clue. So she gains this clue, which is quite helpful. we also have the problem that there is a rumor, and every time there's a reckoning, we will actually lose health. Okay, last but by no means least, we turn over Jacqueline Fine's condition. Replaced by another. In the space between worlds, you encounter a being that can change its shape. The creature seems fascinated with you and asks you countless questions. Test influence minus one. Okay, her influence is one. It's not good. It's not great. I mean, after all, we only need one success, but we'll see how that works out. We roll one die. And we fail. So we spend one focus token and we pass. Woohoo! So one focus goes back in the box. If you pass, place your investigator token on a space of your choice. If you fail, okay, we're going to put her right in the middle of the frozen waste so that she can actually gain this clue next round and then move to lake camp. Again, it's two rounds, but still, it's better than nothing. Okay, so this is a condition, so it goes with the other condition. And that's the end of this round. Now we have the mythos phase, and now we will have to hold our breaths. Oh, good, it's a reckoning. Advanced doom. Advanced the omen track. To the green symbol, we have one green gate. Yep. So that goes, doom goes to four. We have a reckoning. So first of all, monsters. The doll, the cultist doesn't do anything. The doll moves one space closer. Let's zoom out a little. The doll is here. It moves one space closer to the nearest investigator. So that would actually be Lola Hayes, which I'm just going to show you where she is. She's over here. So the doll is going to move to Buenos Aires. Any other monsters? No. No, none that have a reckoning effect anyway. We all lose one health because of the horrible rumor that is in place, and we place one on this. Next up are possessions and conditions. So first of all, we have astral travel for our friend Jacqueline Fine. And for this, she needs to test lore. She has four dice for this test. And she passes. And she flips the card. She passes with two. Evading pursuit and escaping restraints is a trivial exercise. Discard a detained condition or one pursuit condition. She doesn't have either of these, but that's fine. Next up is Lola Hayes, but she hasn't got anything to test for. We have, we have our friend Akachi, who is, well, nothing happens. It's not a reckoning one. Okay. Then we have, first of all, let's see if she can gain a clue, our friend Zoe, and she doesn't. She tests law minus one, so in her case that's three. And she fails. So for her markings of Isis, the price of power is not always easy. Discard this card unless you discard one improvement token. She discards the marking of Isis. And she also has to test for her blessing. And she fails. She loses it. Okay, so then we spawn a gate. And the gate is spawned in Tunguska. Now we're going to spawn a monster there. And it is a flying polyp. What does that do? Okay, well, it's kind of okay. Yeah. It has a reckoning effect, though. Okay, so let's look at the card itself. Oh, God, that's another one that's horrible. The end is nigh. How very appropriate. You've pushed everything to the breaking point. Your mind, body, relationships, and possessions have all been worn thin by the demands of your quest, but you cannot relent, not on the brink of disaster. Each investigator discards one item possession, one ally asset, one task asset, one spell, one clue, one focus, and improvement token. Then each investigator loses one health and one sanity. Oh my God. Okay, now let's see. Let's start with our friend Jacqueline. She doesn't have any allies. She doesn't have any clues. She loses one spell, that's astral travel, one focus. One task asset. Does she have any tasks? No, but oh, she has an item and it's the old journal. She doesn't have any allies. She doesn't have any tasks. She's one spell. She doesn't have any clues and one improvement token. She loses her improvement token for observation. Okay. And then she loses one health and one sanity. Oh my God, she's at death's door. Brilliant. Now, this is a horrible thing to do to us, you know? Yeah, the end is nigh. You've said it. Next up is Akachi. One item, she's gonna lose the secret page. And she's going to... She's going to get rid of the conjuration spell. She hasn't got any improvement tokens. She doesn't have any... Oh, she has one clue. Darn. And she's going to lose one health and one... She's also at death's door. Lola loses one clue. Great. One... One item. First of all, she's going to lose the clairvoyance spell. She's going to lose the elder sign item. Oh no, that's a trinket. Does she have an item? Well, she does, and that's the this one here. So she loses her 45 automatic, so she has no weapon. And she's going to lose the bodyguard. No, actually, she's going to lose the hired muscle. And now, last but not least, our friend who has everything. She's gonna drop the 45 revolver. She's going to drop the Blessing of Isis spell. She's gonna drop her last clue. That is problematic because we require this. Oh yeah, and Lola Hazels needs to lose. She's gonna lose the the witch doctor. She has one focus, which she's going to lose as well. Bloody hell. One improvement token. It's going to be the lore one, or actually the influence one. And she loses one health and one sanity. Okay, I mean, this is really devastating because we need three more clues to solve this. We now have just one person who has a clue. That's Lola Hayes, and she's nowhere near Antarctica. And we have one person who can gain one clue but can't do anything with it until the next turn. So this turn, we can't do anything. This is horrible. Okay, I mean, the end is truly nigh. I mean, let's see how many Mythos cards we've got left. We've got three rounds. There is no way we can win. Okay, but, I mean, it's not over until the fat lady sings, as they say. So we'll have to do this again, and we'll have to do this again, and it'll have to do this again until we are all dead. Okay, now. Regroup. We will start with Jacqueline Fine, who will cast Plumb the Void and try and move our friend Lola to the lake camp. And this is what we're going to do right now. So we have a lore of 4 plus 2 is 6, and she gets to roll 5 dice for the spell, Plumb the Void. But first she does a rest action, because that's really important. And she has 2 successes. So first of all, Lola moves to lake camp. And then we have to turn over this... Discard. The ritual requires an exhausting amount of concentration. Lose one sanity. So she loses one sanity, but that's okay. So that's number one. Hmm. Okay, then let's move over to the sideboard. Lola Hayes is going to do a focus action first, and then she's also going to do a rest action. Okay. Okay. Zoe is going to take one focus action. And that's all she can do, really. Jacqueline Fine is going to do a rest action. And she is going to do... Oh, no! Oh, no, she doesn't. Oh, okay. That's horrible. So she's going to do a focus action as well. And then we have Akachi. She doesn't have anything. She doesn't have a single clue. Well, she literally has no clue. So she can't even look into solving our problematic thing here. So she's first of all going to take a rest action to get back at least one sanity. She's hypothermia, so she can't really gain any health, but she can try and get rid of the hypothermia on rolling a 5, 4, or 6. Let's see. And she rolls a 6, brilliant, so she's not hypothermic anymore, which is good. And she can also now, she can now going forward, well, she's dead on the next turn if we have a reckoning anyway, so that's not good. So we're going to do a focus action here. Okay, so that's about it. Let's go to the encounter phase. Let's start with Lola Hayes. Lola Hayes is going to have a lake camp encounter. Someone has sabotaged the expedition. You search the pit where the drilling equipment was thrown. Observation minus one. Her observation is 2, but she gets 1 additional die. And she has a trinket, a rabbit's foot, which allows her a reroll. She also has a focus. And she fails, so we're going to use the trinket. And she fails, and we're going to use the focus. And she fails again. Okay, so this is absolutely horrible. If you fail, you fall to the bottom of the pit, lose 1 health, and gain 1 back injury. Okay, that was horrible, because now we can't even put anything on the... back injury. When you perform a rest action, you may roll 1 die and a 5 or 6, discard this card. Brilliant. This is brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. Okay, let's see. Can't get any worse. Well, of course it can get a lot worse. Okay, so lake camp. You'll study the corpses of elder things found under star-shaped mounds. Their vile nature distracts you and makes you prone to mistakes. If you fail, test will. Now, the will of our dear friend here is 6. That's Zoe. So let's roll 2 dice. That one came out. Let's try again. That's a fail. 1 pass and 2 more dice. Okay, so she passes. It doesn't matter how she passes. When you pass, nothing happens. Okay, next up is Jacqueline Fine. She does a research encounter in the waste, in the frozen waste, which I suppose is wilderness. You've been exploring the ancient city for hours. Sorry, wilderness. You've been exploring the ancient city for hours. The sun has set, but you continue your investigation. Observation. Her observation is 3. And she fails, of course. Does she have anything that helps her reroll? No. If you fail, you don't notice anything. Lose one sanity and gain one. Oh! I forgot something. We will have to rewind. Because someone got a condition. Namely, a back injury. Now, this is a non-common... This is a common condition. We can turn it over. Fractured spine, searing pain. Hang on. It's non-common. Searing pain suddenly runs up and down your spine. You can barely lift your arms, let alone carry a lot of equipment. It is just okay. So we now know what's going to happen. And now Jacqueline actually gains a clue just for doing this. Or does she? Is this actually... I'm not sure about non-common conditions because I don't think I've ever seen a non-common condition. Do they actually exist? Well, I think all conditions are common. I can only see this in deals where it says common. Strange. Okay, well, I'm not sure if she actually does gain one, but we're just going to say she does. So she has two... of these. Let's just look over here as well. Okay, so she gains one clue and now she's going to have this encounter which she failed, so she is going to do something else. She loses one sanity and gains one illness. Okay, let's lose the sanity and gain one illness. She's poisoned. That's not good. Okay. And finally, Akachi has a generic city encounter. This city is home to an exclusive club for world travelers. You try to convince them that granting you a membership would be a prestigious feather in their cap. It tests your influence. So influence is 2. So minus 1 is 1 die. And she fails. Nothing happens. Okay, mythos phase. If this is a reckoning, Akachi is dead. Oh, it's a rumor. Woohoo! Okay, first of all, spawn 2 clues. Space 2. And 21. Space 1. Like a living thing, the cold has crept to parts of the globe that have not seen snow in eons. You fear that the dreaded Ithaqua is transforming the world to free itself from the frozen prison. Cold white silence. As an encounter, an investigator on Space 1 may search for the cause of the unnatural cold. If he passes, he may spend clues equal to half... well, no. Actually, this is not going to happen at all because... we just don't have enough clues to go around, so we'll just leave it here. On the next reckoning, we'll all get horrible stuff happening to us. So, yeah, but of course, nothing is lost, as I said. Next up, we have, well, we have Lola Hayes. Yeah, I mean, we need clues. Well, Lola Hayes is in a place where she can get clues. We can ask our friend to use the dog sled, which allows her to move one space. This is what we're going to do. And then she has one additional action, so she has two actions. Well, that's not going to help her at all. So she's going to move to the frozen waste. And then she has no actions that she can take. I mean, this is all horrible. This is really horrible. Yeah. Oh, well, she can go to the City of the Elder Things and just try and get rid of those skeletons. And these, you know, she can try and get rid of these. I mean, she can fight some monsters. That's what she's good at. That's what she will do. Okay, so this was one action. So she has two more actions. She's going to do a rest action. And then she's going to move to this place here. You have to first have a research encounter here. Or research encounter on this space. You may move to the city. On the same turn, but she just basically moves through it. Okay, fine. Okay, dokie. So basically, Lola Hayes is just going to do a focus action because there's nothing else she can do. And then hopefully she will be able to solve the lake camp encounter. Akachi, well, I suppose she could move to Shanghai and then have a rest action. So yeah, she's going to have a rest action. Lola Hayes is also going to have a rest action. I mean, there isn't very much we can do anyway. We're just basically sitting around, biding our time, waiting for the end. And Jacqueline Fine is going to have a rest action as well. And she's going to have a focus action. And that's all she's going to do. And next up is Jacqueline Fine. What she's going to try and do is she's going to try and... No, actually, she's not. She's going to move to Lake Camp. Because then we can maybe put two clues on this one this time round. So our friend is going to stay here and get this clue, hopefully. Yeah, well, maybe we have a chance. I mean, we will not solve the fourth mystery because we just don't have time, but maybe we can put two clues on this one. This would be brilliant. So let's start with Lola Hayes. And I know that I'm getting a little bit quick and sloppy about this, but this is actually dragging me down. Lake Camp. You try to decode the dots you found on the star-shaped mounds. Test lore. I mean, this is now Lola Hayes who's going to test lore. She gets one additional die for having completed her personal story, so she rolls three dice. And that's a pass already. If you pass, you translate the creature buried there left incomplete, gain one task unique asset. Sealing the old ones. When you pass a lore test while resolving a spell effect, you may discard that spell after resolving this effect to place one Eldritch token on this card. Then you may flip this card. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So she places her clue. Oops. On the mystery. Next up is Jacqueline Fine. She also has a clue. She needs to pass an encounter. Lake Camp. A man enters the camp having been guided around the world by visions. You discuss the true meaning of his dreams. Test lore. Her lore is 4. And that's a failure. And that's a pass. If you pass, gain one Antarctic guide unique asset. First of all, we're going to put the clue... on this, one unique Arctic guide asset. Henry Wilcox for provisions, old journal, Athanath Waite for the greater good, sacrifice to the blah. Mm-hmm. I hope this is a good one. Prayer, provisions, walking the ley lines, prayer, purifying the world, sealing, blah, mysterious idol, courier run, Sir William Brinton, old journal, mysterious idol, purifying the world, Professor Armitage. Okay, not in here. Let's look at this one, Antarctic guide, here we go, ally. It's got a nice dog too. Once per round, if you are on a space on the Antarctic sideboard, you may re-roll one die when resolving a test, except when resolving an otherworld encounter. Well, that's a good one. We like that one. Brilliant. Oh, sorry. She was poisoned, wasn't she? You cannot... When you perform a rest action, you cannot recover health or sanity. Flip this card. Poison. Sorry, we need to resolve this first. The rash covering most of your body, blah. You are regularly stricken with fits and it has become hard to move, test strength. Okay, well. She fails. If you fail, those around you discard one ally asset and then flip this card. She doesn't have any allies, so that doesn't have any result. Just means that she cannot gain health or sanity. Okay, then we have our friend Zoe, who's going to try and encounter this clue. Wilderness. Captured by the Migo, you are surprised to find that they wish to communicate with you. Really? Okay. Lose one sanity. They offer you weapons to fight the elder things in exchange for your favor. You may gain... No. We're not going to gain Dark Pact. Sorry about that now. But we're going to gain the clue. Brilliant. We're going to lose one sanity. We don't care. Because the end is nigh. I mean, the end is upon us. Okay, last but not least, Akachi is going to have something happening to her in Shanghai. We know from experience with Lily Chen that Shanghai is a horrible place to be. Oh, no, actually, for her, I think it was Sydney. Shanghai. The librarian at St. John's University fears that a cult is trying to steal one of his rare books. You may spend one focus to look through his collection. If you spend focus, you find the book and promise to keep it safe. Gain one old journal asset and improve lore. No. I mean, that's actually not going to help us much. I mean, no, we don't want to do this. Okay, mythos phase. It's another rumor. Everywhere that these... Okay, spawn two clues first. Doesn't really make any difference anymore because we can't get to them. City of the Elder Things. Now that's nice because that's where we are. And this one is on space 15. That's in the middle of here. Yeah. Everywhere that these portals have been reported, earthquakes shake the streets into rubble and sinkholes swallow buildings whole. Dimensions collide. As an encounter, an investigator on Space 11 may attempt to infiltrate the hidden secret, the hidden sect of Chocho's that is destabilizing the fabric. Blah. Yes. Well, when there are no Eldritch tokens, investigators lose the game. We'll lose it way before then. Yes. That's completely... We can ignore that one because it's not going to make any difference to us now. Let's see what we're going to do. Okay, let's turn to the board. We have our friend Zoe. She's going to move to Lake Camp and hopefully clear this mystery. So she's going to do a focus as she can't. So she's just going to do a rest action, get additional stuff back. Plop, plop. Lola... Lola's going to move. And she's going to gain a ship ticket. Jacqueline is going to cast Plumb the Void. And she rolls, she passes 1, 2, and she rolls one more die. So she has 2 successes already, which is really good. So let's see what happens. And she gains 1 success. So she's actually going to move to the plateau of Leng. And then she's going to plumb the void. She's going to turn this over. She loses 1 sanity. It's fine. And then she's going to do a rest action. No, she's going to do a focus action. Okay, and then Akachi is just gonna stay where she is, and she's gonna do a rest action and a focus action. And that's it. So let's see what our friend Zoe can cook up. Lake Camp. The horror of the camp drives one of the pilots mad and he draws a weapon. You try to calm him down, test influence. Well, her influence is 3. And she passes. So first of all, she puts her mythos, her clue on the mystery. If you pass, he relents and you disarm him. Gain 1 weapon asset. Good. So she draws a random weapon. And she gets a spirit dagger. Nice. Next up is, Lola Hayes gets a Miskatonic outpost encounter. The bark, Miskatonic is leaving soon, heading to warmer places. If you're ready on short notice, you can catch a ride. You may spend 1 focus to get back to the ship before it departs. If you spend the focus, you may move to Buenos Aires or Sydney. She's totally going to do this, and she is going to go to Buenos Aires. Well, is she? There's a doll there. No, she's not. She's going to go to Sydney, where she can encounter something equally horrible, namely a servitor of the outer gods. Well, actually, we will not do this. We will not just commit suicide. Let's just deal with our friend Akachi in Shanghai. What happens to her? As you sleep, you are drawn into the realm of dreams by the Monkey King. He tells you that a fish demon has trapped him there. Whoops. You must focus to return to your body. Will minus 1. Now her will is 4, so she rolls 3 dice. And she passes. Woohoo! If you pass, the Monkey King gives you a gift. Improve 1 skill of your choice. Okay, we are totally going to improve our strength. Not that this is going to make any difference at this stage now, but hey. And last but not least, our friend Jacqueline Fine. She's going to encounter this research encounter on the plateau of Leng. Wilderness. A massive windstorm rages through the camp, damaging your equipment. Discard 1 item, possession. In the aftermath, you attempt to salvage what you can. First of all, she... 1 item. Yeah, it has to be that. So she... This is actually annoying, but okay. Now she tests observation and she passes. If you pass, you notice the tracks of elder things outside your camp. Gain this clue. Good. So, this means we are done. And now we're going to draw the last mythos card. First of all, Doom advances because the omen track advances to the blue. And this means 1, 2. Reckoning. Everyone loses 1 health. It's very simple. Everybody loses 1 health. The dole moves closer to the closest investigator, which at this stage is actually in Shanghai, so he's going to move to a space in the middle of nowhere, to a sea space. Let's look at Jacqueline Fine. She loses 1 health because of her poison condition. Nothing for our friend Lola. Nothing. Oh yeah, she can gain a clue. No, she doesn't. And nothing here either. Nope. Spawn a gate. Istanbul. Spawn a monster. Uh, And we get a cultist. That's not so difficult. Okay, now we have to look at all of the other... Discard one Eldritch token from this card. Equal to half the number of... So there would have been 8 on this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 3.5. So there would still be 5 on this. An investigator that does not have a hypothermia condition gains one hypothermia condition, then discard one Eldritch token from this card. Okay, so some poor sod is going to get a hypothermia condition, and we are going to give this to Akachi. Okay. The world shakes event. The scope of the tremor was so vast that newspapers in every country reported on the damage done and the tragic destruction of ancient wonders. Each investigator on the active expedition pays... okay, we don't have this. Okay, we can ignore this one because this is not going to make any difference anymore. We have solved one more mystery. And now we draw the last mystery, and we will also lose on the next turn. Discovery of an ancient civilization. The return of the Miskatonic expedition brought rumors of a strange, unknown civilization nestled in the heart of the Antarctic wastes. But lately there have been reports of these previously unknown creatures all over the globe. After an investigator resolves the research counter, he may spend one clue he gained from that encounter to place that clue on this card. At the end of the mythos phase, if there are clues on this card equal to investigator solve this mystery, we would need four successful rounds for this. So basically, ladies and gentlemen, we have come to the end of this game. But we're going to go out with a bang. We're going to send Zoe... one, because she has this sleigh thingy. And two, to get to this gate, she's going to fight the monsters that are there, trying to do her best to at least close a gate. Yeah, we're going to get reckless now. Because we have nothing to lose. Lola is going to go to Antarctica, where she is going to at least encounter this clue. And Akachi is going to go to... we're going to go out with a bang, ladies and gentlemen. Akachi is going to go to Tokyo, where she is going to encounter the Leng spider, and she'll also try and solve this by closing the gate. So, let's get cracking, people. We'll start with Lola Hayes, who's going to, first of all, do a rest action. All things considered, this is important. And then she's also going to encounter a research encounter. And she's on a wilderness space. No, actually, it's a sea space, sorry. Some members of the crew have been acting suspiciously since you left port. You sneak out of your cabin at night to observe them. Observation minus one. She has one die, but she has three... No, she actually gets another die because she has a special ability, because she passed her personal story. And she passes. So first of all, she gains this clue. And we're going to put this immediately on the discovery of the ancient civilization. Some members of the crew have been acting suspiciously since you left port. You sneak out of your cabin at night to observe them. If you pass, you see the communicating with one of the elder things gain this clue. Good. So, next up is Akachi. Akachi's going to... Okay, now we will need to think about this, because she could, in theory, also get this clue. Okay, we still have one chance. If she kills the Leng spider, she could gain this clue. She could encounter this clue, which would bring it to 3. We could do the same for Zoe, and Jacqueline could... bring herself using Plumb the Void to a place where she could also encounter something. And then we could have 4 clues. Well, we can try this. We will try this. Okay, first of all, the Leng spider. First of all, we have a will test where we roll 4 dice. Now keep your fingers crossed, ladies and gentlemen. We pass. So that is 1 pass. Second pair of dice. Okay, so she loses one sanity, but that's still okay. Now she has to do a strength test. And her strength is 3. And she also has a ritual dagger, which gives her +2. So she gets 4 dice. And she gets 1 success, which means she loses 1 health, but she also gives 1 health to the she inflicts 1 wound on this. Now the question is, can she then actually still have an encounter? Probably not. You can only have an encounter if there is no monster on your space, right? Let's see. Oh, yeah, if there are no more monsters on his space. Okay, well, unfortunately, there are. So our good plan is now, unfortunately, shattered. But that's okay. Okay, I mean, it was a good try. Next up is our friend Zoe. Zoe first encounters the cultist. She has to roll law -1 for the horror check. And she passes. And instead of doing anything else, she actually gains an ally. And she gains an arcane scholar, gain +1 lore. Now she encounters the skeleton. Horror check. Well, she actually has quite a high will. 5, 6, 7, 7. So first we roll 2. That is 1 success. Another 2 is no successes. Another 2 is no successes. So that's 6. Now she rolls the last one. 5, which means she has passed. Which means now she has a really high dice pool. First of all, her strength is 5. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then she gets another die because she didn't lose any sanity during the horror check. And then she has, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, now we need more dice. We're running out of dice. Yeah. It's not good. I actually thought I had plenty of dice. I don't know where they went. Well, okay, again. Here we go. Okay, so she has 5 strength. She gets 1, +1 on fighting. She gets +1 die because she passed the horror check. Oh no, actually 2 additional dice because she passed the horror check. And she gets a +4, which means she gets 12 dice. She loses 2 of these. And we'll see. She needs 2 successes. That's no successes. That is 1 success. Two successes. 3 successes. 4 successes, that's actually overkill. So this is dead. And if you defeat this monster during in a combat encounter, you recover one sanity. So she gains one sanity, which is brilliant. And now she's going to encounter this clue. So, okay, research encounter. Wilderness. You find someone wandering in the wild and notice that he is shackled. You attempt to remove the chains. Strength minus one. Now she has... a strength of, as we said, five. So she gets four. That's a pass already. If you pass, he tells you of an elder thing camp and leads you there. Gain this clue and one random ally asset. I mean, she really gains allies left, right, and center. Now she's gained an expedition guide. When you spend a focus to re-roll a die when resolving a strength or an observation test, you may re-roll up to two dice instead. This is a brilliant one. And we also gain this clue, which we are going to put on our mystery. And then we're going to plumb the void with our friend here. First of all, she's going to do a rest action. No, we're not going to do that. She's just going to plumb the void. Test lore minus one. So her lore is four. Roll three dice. And she passes. So she's going to, move to a clue. And we're going to move her to the pyramids. And then we're going to turn over the plumb the void because she only had one success. So she loses one sanity. That's not too bad, she still has two left, and this is the end of the game anyway, because we cannot win unless we gain, for some reason, two clues. Because the problem is, and this is something that I really don't like, here we have a clue, which we did gain through a prior research encounter, and we cannot use it and put it onto the mystery, because we can only use clues that we've gained after we've started on this mystery, and this is something that I really find very annoying. But it's part of the game, and I guess it keeps the game interesting, so I'm only mildly annoyed. Let's see. Wilderness encounter. The Maigo find you in the ruins of the ancient city. If you have a dark pack condition, flip the condition. Shaken by your encounter, you take refuge in a still-standing building for the night. Observation minus one. The observation is three, so she rolls two dice. But she can spend three tokens on a reroll. She has two focus tokens and one clue, which she cannot use. So that's one, two, three. She passes. Woohoo! So she loses everything she's got, but she gains this clue, which is now going to put onto the discovery of an ancient civilization. Okay, brilliant. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, this is now the end. We will now go to the end game, the Elder Things. We have lost this game because we don't have any more mystery cards, mythos cards to draw from. This is actually kind of an anticlimax, because if we had moved Doom to zero, we would have been able to flip this card and then see what happens. So, we go out with not a bang, but a whimper. Ladies and gentlemen, it was a pleasure as always. I hope you enjoyed this. I really did. I love this game. I really, really have to say I love this game. But I'm going to put it away for a while now, because I have other things that I want to do. Christmas is coming up. My mother was going to travel to Galway today. Unfortunately, she's ill in bed, so we'll have to postpone her travels until next week. Hopefully, she'll be better by then, so you can send positive vibes to my mum. So I'm alone for another week, which means that I may actually break out a game. I'm doing quite well on my studies. So seeing as my mother isn't in, I will actually work on my mathematics at the weekend, this weekend as well. But I may put in a couple of a couple of playthroughs for my Lord of the Rings, the living card game. So thank you all. It has been a pleasure. The ladies were in Antarctica and they actually spent the last couple of turns in Antarctica because it was called Ladies in Antarctica and most of the time we weren't in Antarctica. It was a great game. I really enjoyed it. Again, this is Eldritch Horror by Fantasy Flight Games, using the Mountains of Madness expansions, all small box expansions that are out, and playing against the Rise of the Elder Things. If you are interested in this kind of game, and if you always thought that maybe Arkham Horror was a little too involved or fiddly, having said this, I mean, just look at this. This is also very fiddly, and I've got trays, you know, that actually help me organize my game space, but just look at the amount of cards we've got. I love this game. I can recommend this game. Enjoy. Have a lovely Christmas if I don't talk to you before then. Bye-bye.